Good morning, students. In previous class, what we discussed? We discussed what is the role of vice president. The vice president occupies the second highest office in the country. What are the qualifications of vice president? He or she should be the citizen of India. He should have completed how many years of age? 35 years of age. He must not hold any office of income under a union government, central government, or the local government. He should not have other qualification required to become a member of the Raj Sabha. Then, how was vice president elected? And what are the terms of vice president? Who was vice president elected? The vice president, like the president, is elected not directly by the people, but the method of indirect election. So people not elected the vice president. Vice president elected the elected members. That is indirect election. What is the term of vice president? 5 years term. The terms of office of vice president is 5 years. Then how was removal of vice president? The vice presidents may be removed from his office by a resolution of the Council of State passed by a majority of all the members of the council, and two, agreed by the House of the People. Then what is the function of vice president? The vice president decides the order of the houses. Then he regulates the proceeding of the houses. Then the vice president acts as a president. When he acts as a president, when the president is unable to discharge his duties due to illness or absence from the country, the vice president attends to the function of the president. If the office of the president falls vacant due to his resignation, death, or impeachment, the vice president can act as the president for a maximum period of how many months? 6 months. Then we discussed prime minister. Article 74.1 says, there shall be council of minister with the prime minister as the head to aid and advise the president. The post of prime minister first originated in England and is borrowed from, thereby make us of our constitution. In fact, the prime minister of India has as the counterpart in the Britain is the de facto executive head of the nation. Then what was the work of the prime minister? Our duties and functions of the prime minister. What are the duties of a prime minister? The prime minister designates the rank of his minister and distributes the various department. Then the prime minister informally consult two or three his senior colleagues when he does not convene a cabinet meeting. Then the prime minister supervises the work of various ministers. Then council of minister. Council of minister, after the election, the president of India, on the advice of prime minister, appoints the council of minister. The constitution of India restricts the number of council of minister, including the prime minister, to 15% of total member of Lok Sabha. What are the categories of ministers? It is the one of the two marks. What are the categories of minister? You know, cabinet minister, minister of state, then deputy minister. What is the role? What is the work of the cabinet minister and minister of state, deputy minister? Today class, we are going to see parliament. What is parliament? Then what is the parliament of India? As we studied in earlier class, the Parliament of India is a supreme legislative body of the Republic of India. It is bicameral legislatures composed of President of India and two houses, the Raj Sabha and the Lok Sabha. First, you have to know what is bicameral legislatures, then unicameral legislatures. Uni means one. You know, bicameral means that is two. So, unicameral legislature means a state legislature that has one house. State legislative assembly is a unicameral legislature. Then what is bicameral legislatures? A state legislatures that has two houses, the legislative assembly and the state legislative council is bicameral legislature. Now see Parliament of India. The Parliament is the legislative organ of Union Government. So legislative is also called as the Parliament. What is the work of the legislative? It is a law making body. Then the Parliament of India consists of three part. They are the President, Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha means the Council of States. Then Lok Sabha, the House of the People. The Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is also called as the upper house, and the Lok Sabha is the lower house. It is termed as the bicameral legislature. Then now we are going to see how many members are there in the Rajya Sabha. The Council of States are Rajya Sabha consist of 250 members. So in Rajya Sabha, how many members are there? 250 members, out of which 238 represent the states and the union territories, elected by the method of indirect election. So Rajya Sabha conducted only the indirect election. The 12 nominated members shall be chosen by the president from the humongous person having special knowledge or practical experience in the field of literature, science, art and social service. So how many members are there in the Rajya Sabha? 250 members, out of whom 238 represent the states and union territories, elected by the method of indirect election. Then 12 nominated members shall be chosen by the president from among the person having special knowledge or practical experience in the field of literature, science, sports, art and social service. What are the qualification of Rajya Sabha members? He should be a citizen of India. He should not be less than 30 years of age. He must not less than 30 years of age. Then he should not hold any office of profit under any government. Any government means union government or central government, state government or local government. He should be a person with a sound mind and monetarily solvent, which means he or she must be a person with a sound mind and financially solvent. So monetarily means related to money. He should not be the member of Lok Sabha or any other legislatures. Then what are the terms of the Rajya Sabha members? Rajya Sabha is a permanent house and it cannot be dissolved. The members of Rajya Sabha are elected for a terms of 6 years. Rajya Sabha is a permanent house and is not subject to dissolution. However, 1/3 of the member of Rajya Sabha retired after every second year, every 2 years. A member who is elected for a full term service for a period of 6 years, the election held to fill a vacancy arising otherwise than by the retirement of a member on the expiration of his term of office is called by election. A member elected is a by election remaining member for the remainder of the terms of the members who had resigned or died or disqualified to be a member of the houses under the 10th schedule. So the Vice President of India is the ex officio chairperson of Rajya Sabha. The deputy chairperson of the Rajya Sabha is elected member of the Rajya Sabha. What is money bill? Rajya Sabha does not have any power to amend or reject the money bill. Lok Sabha can only introduce the money bill, and once it is approved by the Lok Sabha, it is passed to Rajya Sabha for its approval. If Rajya Sabha fails to pass it within 14 days, then the bill get passed without the approval of the Rajya Sabha. Have understood, students? Also, Lok Sabha does not need to consider the amendment proposed by the Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha can reject all the proposal and pass it. It is the election of Rajya Sabha. However, the members elected in Raj Sabha. Election to the Raj Sabha are indirect. Members representing states are elected by elected member of the legislative assemblies of the state in accordance with the system of proportional representations by means of the single transferable vote, and those representing union territories are chosen. So the members of the Raj Sabha are elected by the elected members of the state legislative assemblies in accordance with the system of proportional representations by means of single transferable vote. This process of election is called as indirect election, as they are not elected by the people directly. Then Lok Sabha. Then we are going to see Lok Sabha. How many members are there in the Lok Sabha? The Lok Sabha is popular house of the Indian Parliament and contains elected representatives of the people. Here, direct election followed in the Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha as of today has 543 elected members. Out of this, 530 are elected from different states and 13 members from the union territories. The president generally nominates two members. They are belonging to the Anglo-Indian community. At present, the Lok Sabha consists of 545 members. The 545 members. What are the qualification of the Lok Sabha members? He or she should be the citizen of India. He or she must not be less than 25 years of age. He or she must not hold any office profit under the union government or state government. He or she must be mentally sound and financially solvent. He should have his name as electoral rolls in some part of the country. What are the terms of the houses? Normally, the Lok Sabha enjoys terms of 5 years. Raj Sabha, how many years Raj Sabha terms? 6 years terms for Raj Sabha. In Lok Sabha, 5 years term from the date of its first session. The terms of the house can be dissolved by the president on certain occasion on the recommendation of the prime minister, or when the president is convinced of the uncertainty of any group enjoying necessarily majority in the house. The emergency provisions of the constitution enable the president to prorogue or dissolve the Lok Sabha either on the advice of the prime minister or on being convinced that no party or no alliance of the parties enjoy necessarily majority support in the houses. So the emergency provisions of the constitution enable the presidents to prorogue or dissolve the Lok Sabha either on the advice of the prime minister. Then what is the election of the Lok Sabha? The members of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people. Here MLAs, member of legislative assembly, directly elected by the people. So the member of the Lok Sabha are directly elected by the people of the constituencies created on the basis of population. The Election Commission of India arranges, supervises and conducts the election to the Lok Sabha. For the sake of election to Lok Sabha, the entire nation is divided into number of constituency, which are formed more or less on the basis of the population. Universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise means, adult means above 18 years, is followed while electing the members of the Lok Sabha. All Indian citizen above 18 years of age who are registered as voters will vote for their representatives. This house as directly elect enjoy more financial power than the house of the Raj Sabha. Example, money bill can be introduced only in Lok Sabha. Council of Minister are collectively and individually responsible to the Lok Sabha. The Lok Sabha is presided over by the speaker, who is elected by the member. In the absence of the speaker, the deputy speaker elected by the members of the house presides over the session. What is the function of the Lok Sabha? Any bill can introduce and passed in the Lok Sabha, including money bill. Money bill introduced in the Lok Sabha. It has the same power as Raj Sabha to participate in case of impeachment of the president and the judges of the Supreme Court. It has equal power as Raj Sabha in passing any bill for constitutional amendment. Amendment means any changes in the constitution is called as the amendment. Then we'll move on to the speaker. Who is the current speaker of parliament? Om Birla is the current speaker of parliament now. What is the role of the speaker? The speaker's official role is to moderate the debate, make a ruling on procedures, announce of the result of the voters. The speaker decides who may speak and has the power to discipline members who break the procedures of the chamber or house. The Lok Sabha is presided over by the speaker, who is elected by its members. The office of the speaker occupies an important position in our parliamentary democracy. The speaker continues to be in the office even in the houses dissolved till a new speaker is elected by a new Lok Sabha. The speaker presides over a joint sitting of two houses, that is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha of the parliament. He has the power to decide whether a bill is money bill or an ordinary one. While the office of the speaker is vacant or the speaker is absent from the sitting of the house, the deputy speaker presides, except when a resolution of his own removal is under consideration. Parliament session. In India, the parliament conducts three sessions each year. Budget session started in January, February to May, then monsoon session July to August, September, winter session November to December. What is the meaning of budget session? Union budget is the annual financial statement or the statement of the estimated receipts and the expenditures of the central government before the beginning of the each financial year, presented to the Lok Sabha on such day as the president might direct. The budget session of the parliament is normally held from February to May. Then the monsoon session. The monsoon session is held in July to September every year. This after a break of 2 months after the budget session. In this sessions, matters of public interest are discussed. Then the parliamentary years end with a 3 weeks long winter season, which is held from November to December. What is the function and powers of the parliament? The parliament is also vested with the powers to impeach the president and to remove the judges of the Supreme Court and High Court, the Chief Election Commissioner, the Comptroller and Auditor General in accordance with the procedures laid down in the Constitution. The Parliament is the final authority for making laws in any country. In India, it makes laws on the subject of the Union List, Concurrent List and in certain cases on the State List. The Parliament can pass a resolution of no confidence against the Ministry and ask to resign. So, the Parliament of India has the function of the legislation, overseeing of the administration, passing of budget, grievances, discussions of various subjects like development plans, international relation and international policies. International and internal policies. Parliament is also vested with the powers to impeach the president and to remove the judges of the Supreme Court, High Court, Chief Election Commissioner and Comptroller, Auditor General of India in accordance with the procedures laid down in the Constitution. The Parliament has power to change the boundaries of the state. So, Parliament has more power to change the boundaries of the states, any states in India. What we learnt in today's class? Today's class, we discussed what is Parliament. parliament consists of two houses. One is Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. How many members are there in the Rajya Sabha? What are the qualification of the members of Rajya Sabha? Terms of houses of Rajya Sabha members. Then how the Rajya Sabha members elected. Then we discussed Lok Sabha. What are the qualification of the Lok Sabha members? Then terms of the office. 5 years terms, you know, Rajya Sabha members has 6 years terms, then Lok Sabha 3 years terms, 5 years terms. Lok Sabha members directly elected by the people. In Rajya Sabha members indirectly elected the representatives. Then election of the Lok Sabha. What is the function of the Lok Sabha? Speaker. Then we discussed what are the powers and functions of the parliament. Remaining, I will be continuing in the next video.